Hi, welcome. This short video is going to be an ultra crash course in advanced CG production workflow using Alembic. We will export a simple model hierarchy from industry standard Maya, animate it in Blender, add procedural geometry effects in Houdini, and finally assemble the scene back in Maya using Arnold Alembic stand-ins, leveraging Alembic's powerful feature called Layers. Effective exchange of the geometry and animation data between different 3D softwares can be tricky. I'm Gaurav Mathur, let's get started. So here we are in Maya. In its classic outliner, we can inspect the simple teapot model hierarchy with lid and body. Pivots are in right place as well. Scene unit for length is in centimeters. Let's turn off the helper object. And we have UVs going on as well. Now to export this model for animating in Blender, select the teapot, go to Cache, Alembic, Export Selected, give it descriptive name. Let us just import it back to validate. It imports perfectly fine and the model hierarchy is as expected. Very simple. This is Blender. In the interest of time and simplicity, I have prepped up a rather silly teapot bouncing animation looping over 24 frames. An important point to note that there is no deformation, just animating the transform controls available on the parent to child objects. Let's just say this animation now needs to be handed over to FX so that we can add some procedural decimation to the teapot model. To do that, right click on the teapot, select hierarchy, go to file, export Alembic. Let's give it a descriptive name. Check start and end frames are 1 to 24 and make sure selected object is checked mark. That's it. So here we are in Houdini. If you are new to the SOP networks, watching part 2 of this video series is recommended. A sample Houdini file is attached in the video description for your later reference. There are two ways of importing Alembic scenes. The first one is to use the Alembic archive object to create an object level hierarchy representing the Alembic scene. We can turn on the operator tree view to inspect it. The second is to use Alembic SOP and load the entire scene into a single piece of geometry, which is what we currently have here. At the top we have Alembic SOP, which is reading the Alembic archive from the disk. Here we can choose to load the geometry as demand or delayed loaded Alembic primitive. What it means that the geometry loading is deferred until the rendering. As a result, Alembic primitive uses very little memory and can be transformed but can't be edited without converting it to Houdini geometry representation. Alembic primitives store some special properties. These are called intrinsic values in Houdini, which are very similar to attributes, but are computed on demand by Houdini rather than stored. We are going to be using pack transform prim intrinsic data to fetch the move, rotate, and scale values from the exported archive. Transformation is encoded in a 4x4 matrix. In this subnetwork, we are extracting it. This little code is fetching and inverting the full 4x4 transform matrix and storing it as an attribute on the primitive. Next is namesop, creating a primitive attribute called name for lid and body, and promoting it from primitive to the point. Next in chain is where we are undoing the transform to send the teapot to the origin, using the time shift node holding the frame 1. After that we have transform by attributes using inverted transform matrix, which was created in the wrangle node up in chain. Further down is unpacking the Alembic primitive, converting it to polygons, and subdividing it. Moving down, we are breaking the lid geometry using standard Boolean fracture node, giving lid and newly created faces some color, deleting random pieces and packing the geometry at the end of the chain. Next is breaking the body using the standard Voronoi fracture, deleting the random pieces and packing the geometry at the end of the chain like we did with the lid. This stream is keeping the teapot clean as is. Further down we have a switch node allowing easy pick between clean and broken teapot. Rightmost is deleting all the incoming Alembic primitives, keeping only the point representation. And finally down here we are applying the transformation, getting the original animation back. Copying transform matrix attribute on the packed primitives and using transform by attribute. Using a clean SOP at the end, keeping only the path attribute for the hierarchy generation. Before we export the cache for Maya, it needs to be scaled 100 times because we are working in meters inside Houdini and Maya scene defaults are in centimeters. At the end of the chain, we have three alembic ROPs. First two ROPs have alembic layering turned on with replace set as type of layer. In the hierarchy tab, we have build hierarchy from the path attribute turned on. Pack transform is set to merge with parent. In the layering tab, we have it turned on, keeping the full path to the body shape with layer operation set to replace. This ROP is doing exactly the same for the lid shape layer. For the last alembic ROP, we need to pick the clean teapot, layering is disabled and other checkboxes are the same as above. We are back in Maya. To assemble the scene using Arnold Alembic stand-in, let's go to the Arnold menu and drop in a stand-in. Point the file path to the original teapot animation cache. Change the viewport draw mode to the shaded view. Turn on using file sequence and we can see the teapot updating in the viewport. We can also inspect the hierarchy in the file contents outliner. Further down we have area for adding Arnold operators. Operators allow users to modify any part of the Arnold scene at render time. We will cover more on operators in upcoming videos. For now, let's scroll up to the layer section of the alembic setting. Hit add layer, select lid layer.abc to replace the lid with the broken one. We can add another layer which replaces the body with the broken model. A point to remember, operations that a layer performs is encoded in the alembic itself at the time of exporting. We chose to have replace option turned on while exporting from Houdini. Geometry attributes can be read directly by Arnold. Graph the shader and pipe in AI user data color to the base color. Name it CD, throw in a light and hit render. We can turn on the motion blur and bump up the samples to get a cleaner result. And that's pretty much it. Hope you've learned something new. Do provide your feedback in the comment section and don't forget to share this video with someone who you think can benefit from it. Thanks for watching. Until next time.